My dream for the team is to qualify for the Olympics. I feel like I haven't really been able to be totally fulfilled in this process because I know what we can do. And I think that we were getting closer and closer every single year in every quad with amazing athletes and amazing individuals that are coming into the program. And we're so close at qualifying for the Olympics. And that's been one of my biggest dreams. And I know it's one of the biggest dreams of this entire team for over 10 years.
I think we have a lot of potential as a squad. We have great athletes. We are really hardworking. But I think what it's really going to take to make it to the Olympics is having that mentality. Every single time we step foot on the court, whether it's in a game or during a practice, we're playing as if we were playing, you know, to qualify for the Olympics, as if we're playing to, you know, in the gold medal match at the Olympics.
For the team to reach the Olympics, it's a process for sure. Each day is a grind. We talk about the days being long, but the weeks go quickly. So committing yourself to that grind and seeing that as the result.
The experience the past 4 weeks has been kind of like drinking through a fire hose, which is as is expected. We are building things from the ground up. We're developing a strength and conditioning program, a sports psych program, standards of performance on the court. Everyone is all in together to build some much needed systems, and everyone's willing. We have some high level people, and I think one of the big challenges over this past month is to put those high level people in situations they can be successful in. So it's been an exciting process. We've all been learning a ton, and there's a lot of building going on.
In order to qualify for the Olympics, we have to beat some of those European teams, and to get over there is, of course, really expensive. So that has been the biggest barrier since I've been on the team for over a decade now. It's just not having the finances and the resources to get across the water and play those top teams in Europe. We're just missing games, and we're having to play red and white games, which is, of course, really awesome to try to get that competition level going, but to get tangible international games against some of the top European teams is what we've been missing.
Also, just in terms of accommodations and feeling good when we train, like being able to have a good housing that's close to the gym that we can come easily, transportation, and also, you know, food and treatment and locker room situations. I think all those things, people don't really get to see that because those are behind the scene, but those are all things that really help our athlete performance at the end of the day.
For the past 3 years, our family has billeted Team Canada players. We've actually had several players, and we've had Shaina Joseph most recently. It's been a fantastic experience supporting these players and these athletes, and they've really become part of our family. I think it's really important that the community extends support to these national team players. They're phenomenal role models and mentors, not only to our family and our kids, but to the greater community where they spend time volunteering with teams at school, at clubs, and at the provincial level.
It's so important for the community to support these national team players because I think these women can achieve really great things, and without the support they don't have as many opportunities. And I think that these women are such great role models for me and everyone else, and I think fostering that and getting to show that more is really important.
For Canada to make the Olympics, I think it's really important that as coaches and players we understand the primary responsibility by far is on us. We have to train and compete at a level that allows us to play at a high level in high level matches, and you can't short skirt that process. And for us to actually get into the Olympics and then to have a chance to reach the podium in the Olympics, there's no way that's going to happen without the community support and the funding also to make that happen. That funding is going to allow us to get access to those high level games, which we need to compete at a high level. And the community support, there are some critical tournaments that will be on Canadian soil. And we need to have a strong fan support at those matches, and we need to show people that there's strong Canadian support. When we play those home matches, we need to maximize those opportunities because they're critical to where we need to go. And that's where Canada can rally around us and provide some support. So again, this for us to get to where we need to go and get to the podium, which everybody wants, we are all in this together. We all have a role to play.
Give 5 campaign is just the club coaches and the youth players and the club teams across Canada just giving as little as $5 to our program. It's going directly to fund us in the things that are a little bit of barriers for us, such as travel and finances. Super important, and it's just an awesome way to bring the entire community of volleyball, not just in BC and here in Richmond, but it's across Canada completely, and it's a tangible support for the club coaches and the club players to show that they believe in us, that we can qualify for the Olympics. Giving everything I have to this program I've been leading the team and trying to get in community outreach as well, and just knowing coming from such a young age into the national team program, how important it is to have these role models on a national team and giving back into the community. And for me, it's just so important to have the community supporting me and my teammates as well as we really go for the biggest dream of our lives. Many individuals that are wanting to support us and they're asking how we can, and this is one way that's really easy and easily accessible to support us. We just are so close to being able to represent Canada at the Olympics, and we haven't done that in so many years, and we're just really hoping and dreaming and planning for that this can be what we need in order to get to there. From the bottom of our hearts, from me and all of my teammates at Team Canada Volleyball, we really, really thank you for the support, and we can't wait to see where this campaign goes.